Hello, this is Bern, and if you've ever been hurt by trusting your intuition with men, and you are confused because you're not sure what to do moving forward, on today's episode, I'm going to be answering the question, should you always trust your gut with men? Stick with me. Hello, this is Bern. Welcome to your great life. TV.com, a space where I share with ambitious, generous, heart-centered, accomplished women how you can create the relationship of your dreams with no gimmicks, no manipulation, no crazy, stupid techniques as a result of stepping into the most alive and the most feminine version of yourself. That's why I'm here. So, to trust or not to trust your intuition is a question. This is a nuanced question that requires a nuanced answer. It's not black and white, like many things in life. And here's why it's not black and white. Because as a disclaimer, I fully believe that your intuition, when properly calibrated, and that's a big thing, can save your life, can create the most fulfillment for you, can save you from painful, life-shattering situations. And it's something that comes seemingly from nowhere that allows you to have a premonition, that allows you to have a sense that something's not good for you or something's absolutely good for you, despite what others might think. So that's why this is a nuanced answer, because I believe in the power of intuition. I am here as a result of trusting my instincts, and I'm sure that there's many times in your life where trusting your instincts has resulted in something very powerful. So let me start with the base that intuition is good. Here's the problem. Intuition sometimes is confused with other experiences and emotions, and when you consistently go towards those emotions, and it's a fine line between that and intuition, you can get hurt, you can get burned, you can get devastated. I mean, you can experience devastating losses sometimes as a result of confusing intuition with other things. I'll give you a framework of what these three things are. There's probably more, but these are the things that I've seen most commonly appearing in the lives of the women that I've helped and coached. And the one. Number one is chemistry. Sometimes you find that sense of chemistry with someone that you just can't explain. You feel something vibrating and pulsating in every little fiber and cell of your being that draws you to someone. You have no idea why it happens with some and not with others. It doesn't even have to do with the type of person. Sometimes it's the different type of guy that you usually go for, but there's something that's so unique about them in the chemistry that you have, the polarity that's created, that sometimes women feel a strong sense of chemistry and feel, because the chemistry is strong, I should be with that dude. And sometimes it's true and sometimes it's not true. So chemistry has the power to almost like overshadow your intuition. Your intuition might be telling you, don't do it, and your chemistry is saying, fuck yeah, go for it, you know? And it's a challenge because some of these guys, I'm not even talking about like in the most extreme cases, sometimes these are guys that are gonna waste your time, that don't want what you want, who have a different sense of vision for their life than you do. And the problem becomes when it's time to leave them and your brain starts punching you in the gut and saying, for Christ's sakes, leave this guy. And your intuition, so-called intuition, but really chemistry, saying, well, no, stay. Something inside of me tells me I should stay. Yeah, it's your hormones, my dear. It's not your intuition. Sometimes chemistry is confused with intuition. Here's the second common experience that's confused with intuition and hurts you: fear. And this usually comes up not in the sense of not being with someone, but in the sense of taking a risk. Sometimes you need to take a risk. You need to say yes to the right guy, but there's fear. Why? Because the right guy, then all of a sudden, if you stay with him forever, then what if you get bored, right? Or if he's the right guy, all of a sudden you might be emotionally, physically, and spiritually naked in front of him because he really wants to see you and you don't want to be seen. So there's fear around it. Sometimes that fear is confused for intuition. Sometimes your sense of normalcy, your sense of wanting to be in control or wanting to stay in safety, creeps up and punches you, and because your body, your nervous system is designed for surviving, not for thriving, and you want to thrive, then something inside of you is going to kick in and say, ooh, hold your horses, it's too much excitement, maybe too great for you, and like, yeah, stop it. Or it's gonna take more effort, it's gonna take more energy, you could get hurt. But it's the thing you need to do sometimes. Sometimes it's with a job. Sometimes you need to like end it with the employer that you have. Sometimes you have to end it with the person that you're with. But there's this fear that creeps up. So that's the second. And it's so common that people confuse fear for intuition and they don't do the things they need to do because they feel, well, my intuition told me no. And it's not your intuition, it's your fear. Third thing, and this is the actual reason, despite the fact that it doesn't affect everyone, I'm not saying it affects you, my dear, it might, but despite the fact that it doesn't affect every woman that I've helped, it's, I would say it's a minority, but still a significant minority of women, is sometimes darkness is confused with intuition. Here's what I mean. When your experience of love is such that it's painful, if you as a child learn that love is painful, love is abusive, love is just hurtful, shameful, then you have a visceral understanding, level calibration for what love is. So you experience that darkness growing up, and in your mind, at some level, not consciously but subconsciously, this fucked up version of pain is love. So all of a sudden, many years later, you connect with this person who your subconscious picks up this darkness that I experienced as a child. This guy has it. He's gonna bring it with abundance. And even though the guy's smiling, there's something inside of you. Your brain is far smarter than you give it credit for. It's gonna pick it up sometimes and give you the sense like this is the meaning of love that you've created. So sometimes that creeps up and says, my intuition, every part of me is telling me this is an amazing person. And in this specific case, it's not just that the guy is like lazy or whatever. This is a guy who's gonna hurt you. And sometimes that is the problem. You confuse intuition with the darkness or with a failed experience of love that you had as a child. And you go for it and you feel like it's just a natural thing. But natural is not good in that sense, because you learned something that should be abnormal. In your mind, it's normal. So here's what I'm saying to you right now. Should you trust your intuition? The answer is yes and no. You should trust your intuition, and many times it's gonna save your life. However, if your intuition, so to speak, has failed you multiple times, and you've been with guys who are the absolute fucking wrong choice for you time and time again, it might be time to recalibrate your intuition until you can once again trust it and guide you to what you want. There's different ways of doing it. The way I do it is I specific hand-holding. When I do my work, when I help a woman to recalibrate her intuition, she has a sense of what's normal, what's okay, what's not okay. I'm gonna give her a different version of what she's learned, and she's gonna interpret that, make it her own, approve what she wants and disapprove what she doesn't want, and then run with it. Imagine that you learned to fly a plane growing up, but you learned the wrong things. You learned that turbulence is really bad and scary when it's not. Any pilot can tell you that turbulence is not scary for anyone. If you're not wearing a seatbelt, maybe it's scary, but if you're wearing a seatbelt, it's not gonna damage the plane. And maybe there's a couple of gauges in the plane that tell you, very small gauges perhaps, that will tell you, hey, engines are off. So to speak, this is a metaphor, I'm not saying that those, but imagine there's gauges that are small that tell you the engines are off, and you don't learn to actually look at the gauges, something that is actually significantly catastrophic you can miss out on, because your sense of normalcy is different from what could create fulfillment and happiness for you. So in my work, I help women recalibrate that. You might be able to do it with other methods, other therapy, other forms of somebody who's really walked the path and can guide you to it, so that you can learn again what's good, what's bad in terms of a relationship. But I urge you, if you have not, if you've made decisions again and again that are hurtful and you've been calling it intuition, that you at least, if you don't reach out for help, at the very minimum, you ask yourself the question, is this really intuition? Or is it my chemistry? Is it my fear? Is it my darkness of what I experienced? Give yourself the hypothesis situation where you're saying, well, this guy, everything about him is right. Say to yourself, everything about him seems right. It may or may not be. Give yourself more time to test it. Hope this is helpful, useful, insightful, my dear. If it is, I'm going to ask you to do three things. Number one, click like or thumbs up on this video. Number two, if you haven't done so already, subscribe to my channel and hit the little bell so you can get notified of new episodes as they come out. Number three, and most important of all, if you want to take the concepts that I shared with you deeper, there's two things you can do. Number one, on the first line of the description of this video, you'll find a link that will take you to a free masterclass that I've created for you. All you need to do to watch it is enter your name and email and you start watching right away. And it's very powerful and it's free. If you are saying to yourself, dude, I hear you and I no longer want to wing this or try to do this on my own, I want some hand-holding and some help to recalibrate my intuition or to find my soulmate or to let go of excuses or anything that may be stopping you from creating that relationship you want, I don't have 5 extra years to figure this shit out, help me. There's gonna be another link in the description of this video that will have an application, submit it. If I feel I can help you, my assistant will reach out and schedule a time to connect. And if for whatever reason we're not a fit, no harm if we are, then I'll be happy to guide you through this process. Thank you so much for connecting with me. And as always, I challenge you to live a full and a conscious life.